Look for some hazy sunshine on Thursday, some scattered clouds, but a little bit warmer. Good Wednesday night, East Tennessee. David Aldrich, Captain Accurate here from the Captain Accurate Weather Command Center. Well, at McGee Tyson Airport, we hit 40 degrees. Well, what were you calling for? 40 degrees. Ah, that's more like it. 49, the normal high for this time of year. 74, the record high. Now, we did hit 40 also in Oak Ridge, 40 in Maryville, Alcoa, 42 in Teleco Plains, but only the mid-30s for Wartburg and low 30s for Jamestown. As of 8 o'clock tonight, it's freezing outside. 32, 28 Morristown, below freezing. At 25 in Middlesboro, Bell County. There's a little bit of a wind chill. Still feels like it's 17 in Oneida, 20 in Lafayette, and that's because we have a little bit of a wind, about 9 miles an hour. Doesn't take much to make it feel significantly colder in the terms of perception. Now, meanwhile, tracking the clouds, we don't see a whole lot here, but if we were to expand the view, we have some back to the far west, and those north of Dallas rolling through Oklahoma will try and stream in here tomorrow in scattered form. So our headlines, hazy sunshine, scattered clouds, Thursday, then the clouds really increase tomorrow night, and then we'll find maybe a few drops, a few extra flakes, and more aggressively, some snow showers, especially for the plateau and the Smokies. Oh, no, are you saying we're not going to get much? Well, you be the judge. I'm here to present the evidence. You can make your own decisions. That's the most important thing you can do. Now, there's a front west of Kansas City. That's the one we're watching. This is 7:30 tomorrow morning. There's some snow around St. Louis. St. Louis, really not going to amount to much because it moves up toward Indianapolis by midday. All is quiet in Tennessee at that time. By 5 o'clock tomorrow, we're making a run toward 50. I got us at 49 now for Thursday's high, 49. Then here comes the front. And you say, well, wait a minute, I thought there was supposed to be some snow here. Well, maybe, maybe not, at least to start, because it might not really get going until the afternoon. Probably, you see, 1 or 2 o'clock, it gets underway and probably done between 5 and 8 p.m. And that's during the middle of the day when the sun angle is at its highest. So there may not be a whole lot that sticks. You may see some snow, but you may not get some snow. Do you get what I'm saying? Oh, I thought we were going to get some snow. No, probably not. If you're in the Smokies, I think you'll get some snow. But most of us may see some snow and be unimpressed in a hurry. But this is what we're seeing, this big coastal low. Look at the powerful of that low. If that low were to track about 50 to 100 miles further west, it'd be lights out, heavy snows along the I-95 corridor. But it looks like it's just jogging far enough off the Jersey Shore that maybe they just got a couple of inches, but they get pounded in southern New England, because that's where it ultimately goes between Boston and into Maine, where they may find snow in measured in feet, not necessarily in inches. That's a possibility. Heavier snows up there. But then, as we move into the weekend, things quiet down, at least for a little while, before clouds come in on Sunday. But a cold day Saturday. So let me give you the snow statistics, right? Here's one particular model. I posted this online. It shows a nothing burger in Knoxville. Oh, humbug. What's wrong with Knoxville? What did Knoxville ever do to the snowflakes? Why are we getting any? It's all about elevation, my friend. Elevation. You know Crossville is twice as high in elevation as Knoxville is. Knoxville is about 900 feet. Crossville is about 1,800 feet. And you got all sorts of variability in elevation in the Smokies, from Clingman's Dome and Mount Lacan over 6,000 feet. So there could be 1, 2, or 3 inches there. I still think trace to 2 covers about most of everybody. I mean, you may see some flakes in Knoxville, but this is an accumulation map. So make the distinction. Doesn't mean we get nothing. I may see some flakes, but I may just not get any flakes. Does that make any sense? Here's another example of what this nothing burger looks like for Knoxville. Oh, sure, we get some snow accumulating in the plateau, especially for the foothills and Smokies based on this model, but this one's more aggressive all the time. So I show it to you as an extreme on the higher totals. Shows over 4 inches in Sevierville, which may be more indicative of maybe Gatlinburg or Pigeon Forge. So higher elevations could get a couple of inches. Most of us are kind of yawning and go, what was all the fuss about? I don't know why. But we will have a 60% chance that we get some precipitation, and most of it will come down in the form of flakes. Overnight planner tonight, down to 22 by 4. By 21, the overnight low will be clear for now. Mostly clear overnight, and winds will be out of the north-northeast about 3 to 8 miles per hour. Low temperature by morning, 13 Middlesboro, 19 Morristown in Newport, 22 in Teleco Plains, and 20 in Kingston. about 15 in Oneida. That's a cold start to your Thursday, even if the sun is shining in hazy form. So hazy sunshine, you might think it's mostly sunny at times, but then there's some scattered clouds that come in and move out from time to time, but we'll make a run into the upper 40s to near 50 degrees. Could someone else get to 50? Absolutely. Maryville, Alcoa, you might hit 50. Newport, 50 degrees, the expectation for you. 52 in Teleco Plains and 49 in Oak Ridge. So generally, we're in the upper 40s to near 50 for your Thursday high. Oh, yes, and the groundhog says, miss me? Sure you do. Yeah, yeah, look, he's breathing. Hey, if you watch closely, his nose will twitch. I think I saw it. Oh, he's definitely breathing. Just 7 days away. He is just waiting to give you his opinion, his prognostication on the 2nd of February. Here's your Captain Accurate Weather Authority forecast for Knoxville, East Tennessee. 42 degrees, not very promising for snow. If we get up like 1 o'clock, get up to 40, 42, and then we see this precipitation come in and is maybe starting off as some rain. That's a possibility. But it does turn sharply colder on Saturday. Your Saturday plans will feature lots of sunshine, but it's cold. 14 to start, 30 to finish. So it's one of those days that never gets above freezing. But then we're in the mid-50s by Tuesday, 1st of February. It's a brand new month, a brand new attitude with more rain coming in on Groundhog Day, which, of course, is Wednesday of next week. By the way, you can keep track of it all using the Captain Accurate Weather app, now with Pete Michaels Traffic. Weather and traffic, perfect together and at your fingertips. It's free. Keep you and your family safe. Just search Captain Accurate at the App Store and Google Play. Well, my name is David Aldridge. Some people call me Captain Accurate. It's not easy being accurate, so weather doesn't surprise you. We'll see you here next time. Take care.